Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Ismaili Center, Toronto. We are very, very pleased to have you here this evening. My name is Zulfikar Hirji, and I'm responsible for thematic public programs here at the Ismaili Center in Toronto, as well as the Ismaili Center in Vancouver. I know many of you have come here for the first time tonight, and I think that this is an opportunity for me to say a few words about the Ismaili Centers around the world and about the work of the Ismaili Centers, and then, of course, turn it over to your hosts and our hosts, our joint hosts tonight, and to tell you about the program. I'd like to just begin by saying that the Ismaili Center Toronto was opened by His Highness the Aga Khan in September of 2014, and it has been a wonderful opportunity for us to bring this new and dynamic space to Toronto, but also the Aga Khan Park and the Aga Khan Museum will share the site with us. It's been a wonderful opportunity over the last almost 2 years now to develop new relationships and new partnerships with a whole range of communities in Toronto, in the region, as well as internationally. And we're very, very pleased tonight to have this wonderful program on Turkmenistan. The Ismaili Centers were established to build bridges with various communities within Toronto, internationally, also within the Muslim Ummah, and with many other faith communities to bring together civil society communities, as well as people interested in resolving and talking about the very human problems that face us all. The Ismaili Centers are also a place where we try to shed new light and new knowledge on questions that are of concern to us all, to share our cultures, to have dialogue, and to really engage and foster new conversations. And the Ismaili Centers are places where we can also launch new ideas. Think about ways in which we can change the conversation about many issues that are facing us and bring the latest and most resilient kinds of knowledge and ways of resolving questions. And this is what we hope that the Ismaili Centers will do here in Toronto and around the six places in which the Ismaili Centers are housed around the world. There is, as you may have heard, an Ismaili Center in Dushanbe, in Tajikistan, which may be familiar to you. We have an Ismaili Center in Dubai, in Lisbon, in London, and I think that I just mentioned the Ismaili Center here, and of course in Vancouver. The Ismaili Centers are really a new home for many Muslim cultures around the world, as well as non-Muslim cultures. But tonight, I think the program is going to shed light on some of the wonderful experiences and culture that is historical to Turkmenistan, but also more contemporary and modern. And we cannot think of any other community that we would like to work with and partner with than the Durdy Bayramov Art Foundation, which is our co-host right along with the Embassy of Turkmenistan in Washington, D.C., which has hosted the classical experiences of Turkmenistan and its culture and its music. So without further ado, I'm very, very proud and happy to welcome you all here to the Ismaili Center this evening and to turn it over to our Master of Ceremonies. Thank you very much and enjoy the evening.
On behalf of the Durdy Bayramov Art Foundation, I would like to welcome each on the history of Turkmen music and in the hearts of the Turkmen people. Bayramov and Halmammedov were very much alike. Having lost parents at a young age, they were both brought up in an orphanage and chose to devote their careers to the arts. These two acclaimed artists were close friends who supported each other in their individual endeavors and held tremendous respect for one another's artistic vision. Theirs was a friendship that compelled Bayramov to paint expressive portraits of the composer, while Nury Halmammedov composed an emotive piece dedicated to the painter. It is now my pleasure to welcome the musicians who will be performing tonight's program. They are none other than the talented soprano Durdy Bayramov from the Helicon Opera in Moscow, as well as talented Turkmen pianist and composer Ismaili Center. We are also very lucky to have the winner of the Nury Halmammedov International Piano Competition, talented Turkmen pianist joining us this evening. Begeçdeyev has worked internationally with the Moroccan Symphony Orchestra and currently resides in Montreal. At this point, I just want to request that we all put our phones on silent as we embark upon a transcendent musical journey to Turkmenistan, a land of splendor and warmth. In the spirit of celebrating the richness of Turkmen culture and heritage, we begin this evening's program with a song from the Turkmen film, Şükür Başlı. This is based on a true story about a Bukhara
Thank you. Поделитесь, пожалуйста, своими впечатлениями от концерта.
Но прежде всего я хочу поблагодарить организаторов за такой волшебный, можно сказать, концерт, потому что звучат музыки с нашего детства, с наших любимых туркменских фильмов и наш любимый композитор Нуры Халмамедов. Вот, поэтому, когда слушаю эту музыку, это не просто музыка для меня, а это история всего нашего народа. Большое спасибо еще раз организаторам этого концерта.
Mr. Elefant, it's great to see you here today. It's one of a kind and the first concert of Turkmen classical music in North America. What do you think about this event as MP and on a personal level?
As an MP, I think it's wonderful that we have the variety of cultures we have in Canada, and we have people who are willing to put that culture out and invite others to learn of it, and Canada is just richer because of it. Personally, I enjoyed the music. And I have seen the art before. I've been to the gallery and I've explored the art. And I love the variety and the vibrant colors. And it has taught me something about Turkmenistan that I didn't know before. The music adds to it. And I think the reality is that the art is a feast for our eyes. The music is a feast for our ears. And together they're a feast for our hearts.
Amazingly said. Since it's the beginning of the journey, would you like to see a continuation of this event?
Well, I'll be encouraging the foundation to certainly keep doing this, to keep letting people know about it so that more Canadians can explore the rich. We don't know much about Turkmenistan. Canada just is fairly naive or ignorant about that part of the world in Central Asia. And this opens up and demystifies it and helps us to explore its Western and Eastern. It's a bridge country between the East and the West. And music like this, I think, makes us richer and makes us better neighbors in the world.
We represent Russian-speaking community of Toronto, all those who came from the former Soviet Union, including people of Turkmenistan. What would you like to say to our televiewers?
Well, I was quite impressed tonight that we had a Russian singer who was singing very clearly in Turkmen language. And I thought that was quite wonderful to show the multicultural nature of the countries that made up the Soviet Union and how the friendships that started in the Union continue on in independence. And we cherish that independence, but we're very glad that the cultures work together and we're all richer because of it.